Let's get started. I know some of the deputations have brought cardboard figures with them, but please don't put it at a high position so as not to obstruct my sight line, please. I would like to welcome the deputations and individuals attending today's meeting. I'll invite you to speak one by one. Every deputation and individual will be given 3 minutes to speak to enable the smooth conduct of the meeting. The secretariat has arranged for the installation of an countdown clock. Deputations and individuals, the submissions that you have given us, as well as the oral submissions, will not be protected under the Electrical Powers and Privileges Cap 382 Ordinance. Ms. Chen Hoi Chi. Yes. I'm from a concerned group on grassroots housing issues. Under our organization, we have groups representing people living in subdivided flats, cubicles, and so on. And they ask why we are trying to take away people, destroy people's homes to give way for a low-rise residential, luxurious residential development. These are people who are paying high rent in cubicles, in subdivided flats, and so on. We don't think we should destroy people's fields and houses to facilitate residential property development. I think the government is making use of the very poor housing conditions of the grassroots to force new territories residents to have their residences destroyed to give way for public rental housing and other residential development. So this is not fair because first, PRH will only account for a small part of the development. And second, is it really fair that less well-off people can only live in the new territories but not in the urban district? And there are many areas that we can develop in the urban district rather than the Northeast NT. And just next to the Northeast NT, we have the golf course with a comparable size. Why don't we turn this golf course into residential land? So we find this difficult to understand, and we won't accept the proposal. And we can also learn from Tong Chong and Tin Sui Wai. That's not a very good experience for those who are allocated PRH. They are grassroots, they work as waiters, or cleaning workers, or security guards. They have to go out to work early in the morning, or they may have elderly parents to take care of, so they need a good social network. So we want to have public rental housing in the urban district. We can have a lot of sites in the urban district. For example, the former Kong Man Chun site and former police quarters site. These lands are more suitable for the purpose we have in mind. Mr. Yong Ho Chun or Mr. Harry Yeung from the Liberal Party. I'm Harry Yeung. The Liberal Party support the development in relation to the Northeast NT new development area. We have a bottleneck, and that is a shortage of land So the Northeast NT will provide the land we need, and this is an opportunity we must seize. Although in an earlier consultation exercise, there were people asking for the plan to be withdrawn, but the consultation has been going on for a long time. If we go back to square one, we will never make progress. Many young people are asking why property prices are so high that they can never afford to buy their own homes. It's because there were little effort in the land development. In 03-04, there were 26 private flats provided to the market, and then in 09, it dropped to 7,000. In 2010, there were 13,000, and then it dropped to 9,000 something. At first, we thought this year we are going to have 12,000, but up to October, there were only 6,845. So there's a shortage of 5,000, and it's estimated that we won't be able to get 10,000 this year. As the supply has dwindled, the property prices have gone up drastically. We cannot sit on our hands and do nothing, otherwise it will continue to rise. So we need to get the conditions right for Northeast NT. For example, there must be complementary measures. There should be commercial activities so that job opportunities of different scaled can be provided. And there must be railway to tie in with the development so that the new development areas will not be isolated pockets of underprivileged cities. And we must make sure that Hong Kong people get the priority in getting the flats. So for private residential development, we should make it a rule that at least half of the flats should be for Hong Kong people. We can never allow this new development area to become the back garden of a richer mainland people. And we don't want to have a visa-free entry for these mainlanders. And there should also be rules on the sizes of flats, so that we won't allow this to become an SAR within an SAR for rich mainlanders. And also we must help those who are affected by the development to relocate. There should be reasonable compensation. Next, we have Mr. Gut Chow Song, Ms. Gut Chow Song. This is my 3 minutes. I want to remain silent for some time. This is the first time I attend a panel meeting of this council. I don't know why you call this a meeting. A meeting should be for a group of people who get together to discuss some issues. There should be some verbal exchanges. And now, only we are talking here with no response from the administration. It seems that we are taking an oral test. And when we have finished, that's the end of the matter. If this is the case, why bother to come? We might as well just give you a written submission. We are willing to discuss the subject, the issues. Many people are sincere by attending the meeting. But I don't know whether the administration is listening with heart, whether they are sincere in having a discussion. Anything else? No, I would like to know why there's no response. Well, you may have already given us your written submissions, and today we have this public hearing so that you can come and express your views, so that members can learn about your views and there will be a question time for members in a moment. And of course, we are going to invite the administration to respond to you. Procedurally, it's now the time for you to express your views. You can supplement what you have provided in your written submission. The important thing is the written submissions have all been circulated to members. So you may wish to supplement what you have already told us. You have 3 minutes. But there's no discussion in the procedure. We have 35 and then 35 deputations, and then we can speak for 3 minutes, and that will leave us 15 minutes for discussion. So we'll listen to you first. Your point is noted. You have still got some time left. I would like to have a discussion, impromptu discussion, so that we can really achieve something. Anything else? If not, I'll ask the next one to speak.
Okay.
Next, Hong Kong Force Planning Action Group, Mr. Cheng Tin-Cheng. Now, I also feel that there's a lack of discussion. I am surprised that Mr. Paul Chen went to the mainland and yet he wouldn't come here to listen to people's views. So you can see that the Development Bureau is paying attention to only certain people and overlooking the views of others. Now, previously, I saw people in public hearings cite a lot of data and figures. Now, the NDA plan is not properly backed up with information. I asked the officials, what qualifies you to tell us that this is not for Shenzhen Hong Kong integration? We have a bunch of technocrats sitting here, and yet they cannot answer our questions. The entire document is merely cover up. Now, if you look at the first paragraph, it tells you about the background of the scheme, and it says that it all went back to the 1990s, and then it developed from there. This has nothing to do with CY Leung. It's a policy that developed from a long time ago. Now, Northeastern New Territories is positioned as a strategic piece of real estate. It was decided before the reunification. Now that's absurd. Now this is proposed by Donald Zhang in 2007, and the officials tell us, well, actually Mr. Donald Zhang didn't want to embark on it. He kept dragging his feet. There were a lot of studies and public engagement phase 3. Now, after CY Leung came into office, it was proposed at the end of June by Mrs. Carrie Lam. So many people dislike CY Leung. You can't deny that. Now, also, Planning Department, when will you return to Hong Kong people the 1,200 hectares of land and use them for public housing? Now, this is Hong Kong people's property. You must return this 1,208 hectares before you touch NENT. Next, CU Agro. Mr. Lau Hoi Long. This is an organization made up of students. We focus on the source of our food. We have been educated on the basis that Hong Kong is an international metropolis. New York, London, Tokyo, they have developed urban agriculture. Hong Kong hasn't. It's not just for farming. Agriculture can resolve the landfill issue. The food remnants can become fertilizers. Now, people ask, why do you grow so many vegetables? You have the Food Safety Center, and yet we've seen not long ago that there was in the market waste oil being marketed as for food purpose. Now, maybe we don't have enough land to grow all the vegetables we eat. We have nearly 4,000 hectares of fallow agricultural land, and that's 200 times the Victoria Park. Now, and that would feed a lot of Hong Kong people. Now, people say that we've been okay eating vegetables from the mainland. We do a lot of testing. Now, in 2006, a mainland official said that 60% of agricultural land in China has been contaminated seriously. 10% of Chinese people do not have vegetables for consumption. So where do we get an assured supply of vegetables? So we university students feel that the development of local agriculture is important for the sustained development of Hong Kong. The food education of Hong Kong has been a blank for over 20 years. It has not been taught in class. We need to gain a fresh understanding of food and agriculture. I hope that in future generations, we are able to see and feel agriculture and farming in Hong Kong, to see how food is grown from sunshine and air. They don't have to go to Taiwan to see farms. NENT is very important for our agricultural talents or practitioners. So we need to preserve this piece of land and keep our farmers here. Young people should have the choice to decide which route they wish to take. Long live Hong Kong agriculture. Next, Ms. Wan Hoi Ying. Now, I'm a resident of Peng Che Ta Ku Ling. First, I make a solemn declaration that the Ta Ku Ling Village Committee, they made a written submission, 101RC12. This does not represent the views of non-indigenous residents of our area. Now, the meetings held recently do not provide answers to the questions we have asked. It's merely like playing of a recorded tape. The same words are being repeated. Now, the residents of the three NDAs request that the public hearing be held afresh, and we demand that Mr. Paul Chen and the officials concerned must take part in that public hearing. The villagers of the three areas do not mind coming, even though there might be many elderly people among us. We will come to No matter how many sessions of public hearing are held, we want to voice our aspirations to those officials. We hope that you will listen to us. And I demand that the brainwashing advertisements in respect of the three areas, that they be stopped. They deceive the public. You forcibly remove us residents. Choi Yun Village was a concrete example. You removed them by force. Now that is the reality. What you've been saying have been false. They give people a pretty picture. They describe the beautiful life that people will enjoy once the original residents have been removed. All these are lies. What kind of government is this? They keep telling lies. Are we a communist country? Are we deceiving our residents? Well, unlike in other places, we are not being thankful for what you give us. In Hong Kong, we have freedom of speech. Now, government officials, whatever ranks they belong to, keep saying lies all along. Your time is up. Next speaker, please. Ms. Chow Kai Kai, Fanling North, Villagers Alliance. Now, who are you? Can you introduce yourselves? Who are the officials concerned? The meeting can be chaired by the vice chairman of the panel. Well, you will be given a bit more time for the time you just used up. Now, NTNE's development is very important. It's been the most major piece of development for the past three decades. Now, so many residents have come a long way to this meeting, and yet Mr. Paul Chen is not here. And we do not see many pro-establishment members here. Now, have those members been paying proper respect to the public, especially to those villagers who have come to such a long way? Now, as the speaker just mentioned, Mr. C.Y. Leung is faced with residential problems. Now, he knows that this is very controversial. Many villagers do not want to leave their homes, and yet he tries to divide the public. Now, this is not proper for a leader of Hong Kong. We express our strong dissatisfaction on behalf of our areas. Not only do we represent the four villages, we represent the entire Hong Kong public. This is about the land resources of the entire Hong Kong population. Now, I give you a few figures. In Hong Kong, there are 200,000 vacant homes. This is government figures. We have actually a lot of supply, but there has been unfair allocation. The government doesn't collect real estate taxes, and yet it abolished rent control, and many people ask what's the basis for the development. We want to defend our homes. We have looked at the figures supplied by the government and the real estate developers. We do not see any solid grounds. It said that there will be 8.4 million people by 2030. There's no basis for that. We are strongly against the NENT development and we demand that it be withdrawn. Withdraw the scheme. I hope you will all hear this. Next. Mapo Community Farm, Ms. Al Heyman, Chairman, Vice Chairman. I am a locally born resident of Marcy Po, and I'm a member of the farm. We are against the plan. It has already damaged our lives. Once the development plans have been announced, the developers came, tried to assemble land. Henderson Land, they bought the land and they threw the asbestos into the river and they surrounded Marcy Po village with wire mesh. The government said the owners of land can do whatever they like. Now they are condoning such evil conduct by the developers. This is collusion between the government and the developers. Now, is the development of NENT really for the good of the community or is it for the sake of developers? Now, at our farm, when we had the land, the farmers could earn their living. They didn't have to buy fertilizers. Now, we cover the food waste and we are able to grow the land. Now, the farms are actually resolving food waste issue and we produce the food for the community. People come to buy vegetables. They are not just consumers, they are also producers using food waste. We are building our community. Our land. We will not dissect the city from the farms. The two are part of each other. Development must be people-based. Development must not disrupt people's homes. Pay proper respect to the residential rights of the villagers and they must have choice. This is damaging the villages, the rural areas. The government should buy back from the developers all the agricultural land and return them to the farmers. We demand homes. We do not want developments that damage our homes. No demolition. Do you hear that, Liberal Party? Those above, please do not shout aloud. Next, Mr. Shang Si Wing, Chairman. I am a villager of Marcy Po village. Now, I have brought something for you to see. This is sweet potato organically grown. This is the regular sweet potato that you see in the wet market. Now, the government officials have been deceiving the Hong Kong public. The organic food that we consume every day, whether it's pork, chicken, meat, or vegetables, there's a lot of chemical fertilizer in it, harmful substances, and yet this is not informed to the public. The damage is not informed to us. Why do we grow organic vegetables? Because I have found that the pork that I ate contained contaminants or fertilizers which I could smell. The government should use NENT for the sake of agricultural production in Hong Kong. The government has been partial all along to the developers. The financial sector the Development Bureau chief is not here. He is in charge of NENT development, and yet he doesn't show up. Now, it's just like they merely post a notice on the street side. The government says in advertisements that you will be offered a very amenable environment in the Northeastern New Territories, but they don't tell us that we are being fed poisonous vegetables. So is it also being partial to the mainland? Do we have the capacity to develop our agricultural sector? Yes. We have enough resources. That would resolve part of the food waste issue, the landfill issue. You spend billions to develop those projects. Why don't you use the billions on agricultural development? No resettlement, no demolition. Next, Mr. Yong Kin Sang. I'm a villager of Marcy Po. I'm against NENT development. Now, you in the previous public engagement exercises, you treated objections as support. That's absurd. And now you have broadcast all sorts of propaganda through the media. Now, what's the main point of the development? You say it's to offer people homes. Now, every time I see the advertisement, I feel as if salt is being rubbed into the wound. Now, you say Shenzhen, Hong Kong will be integrated, etc. We are receiving letters from law firms or telling us that we will soon have to be forced to move, and yet no safeguards are provided. This is unfair. Now, the residents will become homeless. Many families do not qualify for public housing, and yet they cannot afford expensive private housing. So we are being forced to move to cubicles and subdivided units. And whereas those living in subdivided units will be moved to the new areas, this is very absurd. Now, many farmers have grown vegetables all their lives. They merely ask for a home. It's not very much to ask, and they live with their families, but this will soon come to an end. They will be forced to move to homes and be separated from their families. What have they been guilty of? Now, they are labeled as greedy people who demand all sorts of compensation. Also, the non-indigenous residents in NENT are being forced to move by the developers, and yet the government does nothing. Is it that NENT residents are supposed to have less rights than others? Now, the government says this is there's nothing they can do under the law, and they offer no help to the residents, so the developers are able to kick these residents out as they wish. So this is so-called public private sector joint cooperation, and the developers get their way. Now, the residents become sacrificed. Now, this is unfair. The people will become more and more aggrieved.
No eviction, no demolition. Withdraw this rotten plan. Next, Ms. Wong Suk Wai. I also have a question. Since Lau Wong Fa and Mr. Paul Chen are not here, so will they be, you know, reading the views or submissions that we've made today? Well, you've all sent in your submissions, which will be circulated to all members. So that's one approach. What happens if we don't have any scripts or written submission? I've not written a submission. I think the proceedings today are being videotaped. Will they be viewing the recordings? Whether or not they will do that, I can't answer the question on their behalf. Thank you. You may now start. I'm Kai Fong from Marcy Po Village and also a member of the farm there. What I wanted to say had already been said by many of the other deputations, including Ms. Chek Kai Kai. We object to this scheme because the government is saying that there is a need for development because there is a shortage of land. Many people have already made the same point many times already. For example, our friends from the Liberal Party. I don't think you need to, lie to the people of Hong Kong by twisting your words. Somebody said that if we were to withdraw this plan, then Hong Kong would not be able to move forward. I'm not a native villager. I only moved into the village 2 years ago. I grew up in a public housing estate. And I used to live in the urban area, which is very convenient. I can go to the McDonald's at any time, and transport is very convenient. After moving into the village, I've also joined the community farm in the village. I see that in Hong Kong, other than the mainstream lifestyles, there are alternatives. We can live in villages, we can live in huts, we can choose to work for a living or stay in the on the farm and cultivate our land. We've set up a community farm because we're concerned about agriculture. We're also concerned about this development proposal. That's why in the village we are supporting the farmers to conduct organic farming. We help them to sell their produce and of course, they also provide us with the food stuff. Well, if you want to develop properties or shopping malls, what will we get eventually? What will we get other than money after we've made so much profit? And if all the farmland of Hong Kong disappear, do we have to rely on the contaminated vegetables from the mainland, or do we have to, you know, import food from other countries, costing a lot of, pollution? I think we should all reflect on this. I've seen many Kai Fongs, even though the development has yet to start, they are now being forcibly evicted by the developers, and they are subject to a lot of nuisances. They want to redecorate their homes or make investments on the land, and they would not dare to do so. So I think all of our lives have been very much disrupted, and we are also very concerned. And this has been we have been living under a lot of pressure over the last decade or more. I would really like to invite the secretary or the chairman, if I would urge them sincerely to listen to the recordings of our proceedings today and come to our Fanling and Ping Chair for a visit. Mr. Paul Chen, I heard recently that Paul Chen will come to our village and subsequently only made a tour of the village sitting in a car. So if you really are concerned, I would like to invite them to really come and see how the Kai Fongs in these few villages live. Mr. Poon Wai Tak. My name is Poon. I have been severely affected by the Northeast Anti-Development Plan. I discovered that since the Hanover because we have many problems, including this development. Which mainly are telling me for the rich. For those who want to become self-reliant, there's no room for them to do so. The hawkers and the small grocery stores are driven out of business. The NT has always been discriminated. During the rainy season, for example, when the observatory sees that a major rain area on top of Hong Kong Island, they will immediately hoist a black rain signal. If the rain bell stretches from Tin Moon to Shuttlecock, they would only issue a North District rainstorm warning. So the NT has always been subject to discrimination. The NT, Northeast NT development plan, is even dividing the NT residents, which originally have been subject to discrimination. Originally, the landlords have lots of land. They were not able to take care of all such land, and they would lease some of the land to people like us who are non-indigenous residents. We've maintained a very good relationship. Subsequently, this Northeast NT development proposal was announced, and as a result, our relationship has been adversely affected. And the people the people living in the NT are being divided against themselves. When the landlord learned about this plan, and when there's interest involved, they've started to lose their own direction. They no longer lease out the land, and because of this plan, they will just leave the land, abandoned, and say nobody is willing to farm the land. Actually, the number of people queuing up who want to farm land actually exceed the number of people waiting for public housing. And these landlords even pour concrete onto the fields so that there's no chance for the land to be resurrected as farmland. A landlord even, because of this plan, a landlord even said that even a machine gun would not be able to shoot down a few people. In order to support this proposal, he didn't have the he was willing to even to sell his ancestral shrines. He said he was willing to give it to the government. At the same time, he said that the land could be sold. He didn't have any backbones at all. I'm absolutely against the Northeast NT development plan. We are the non-indigenous villagers living in the NT. We are willing to stand on our hind legs, and we urge that this rotten development plan be scrapped. Ms. Yip Chi Kiu. Good afternoon. Today, I'd like to share with you a story in this book. And then within these 3 minutes, I think you take a deep breath, because the story is a true story. In the States, there is a mom called Jennifer Stewart, and she had three children, two of whom suffer from serious autism, one of which is even blind. A well-renowned psychic tried to help her find out what was the reason. It was found out that the mother was used to be a reporter in her previous life, and she wanted to report on how the Jews were being treated in Europe, and she encountered many difficulties. Her two children were also brothers in a previous life. They actually work in the propaganda department of the Nazi Germany, and they become reincarnated as autistic children, because they had in their previous life chose to bury the truth and work for the Nazis, and that's why in this life they have to learn about the value of truthful communication. For people who don't know the full picture, may I ask what is the reason why you support this Northeast NT development plan, which is based on lies? If you regard Hong Kong as your home, why would you tolerate? What would you become an accomplice to someone who would like to ruin the future of Hong Kong? If because of your personal interest, you say you don't have any choice, that would only be, that is only fear. Money and power has actually caused you to lose your own direction. I hope you really, you know, regain the courage as a human being. And if you decide to change your mind, you're welcome to join us on the side of justice and, you know, make good use of your position. Otherwise, what you choose today, you'll be paid back in the future. I believe the government is not a machine. It comprises of a group of people who so I hope the literal members who are from the pro-establishment camp who are not present here, and the officials are not present here, only if you are willing to really, you know, act according to your conscience, you can still do some good. I hope that like the anti-residents, like the indigenous residents in America, I hope you'll be able to really defend your homeland, because your ancestors will be proud. I hope the Hong Kong government will repent in time and immediately withdraw this Northeast Anti-Development Plan. Next, Mr. Au Lau Khan. Good afternoon. I am a villager born in the Marsipo village. I am a farmer. I am against the development plan for Northeast NT. My parents arrived at Marsipo in the 1950s. They, you know, dig up the well and they actually, you know, carve out the farm, and they also built our house, and they brought up 6 children. So a lot of sweat and tears have been, spent. And now a whole family comprising 3 generations live in the village, and we relied on farming for a living. But by the time it's my generation, both myself and my family will be losing our homes, because we now have this development plan for Northeast NT. I'm really angry. In order to develop, the administration has never respect the local villages. I think the land there has actually, enabled the 3 generations of a family to make a living. To the farmers, the land represents their lives. The government has now come, is now coming to rob us of our land. It's like taking our lives away. Without our farmland, we wouldn't be able to make a living. Without our homes, what are we going to do? The administration suggests that we should resurrect the abandoned farmland, and that we should relocate to Futai Au and Long Valley. But there are already people living in those 2 areas and farming the land there. Is the government suggesting that we should force those people out so that we can move in? In Futai Au, there are few large fish ponds where people are doing fish farming. Is the government going to fill up those ponds so that we can farm there? If Hong Kong develop in this manner, will we ever have any more farmland? If you want to farm, you have to understand the nature of the soil and the ecology in the area. You have to nurture the soil. You have to build up your distribution network. This may take 5 or even 10 years or longer. In Marsipo, we spend the 3 generation in our family have worked hard over the years before we've come to the present stage. Do you think it's very easy to simply revive farming? Don't ask people to revive farming, lightly. You have absolutely no respect for farmers. So no eviction, no demolition, and withdraw this rotten plan. Mr. Chung Chi Ho, I have a question for the officials present today. For the submissions that we've made, would you also respond by telling us that while you support the development plan, you have different views? I heard earlier that so long as you provide alternative views, you will be labeled as in support of this proposal, and then there will be other views. I think your comments and the comments made by other people are very clear. I personally would assume that that is the case. Perhaps you may now start. Okay. I'm a farmer farming in Masibo Village. First of all, I must state that I object to the development plan for Northeast NT. I want the government to withdraw the plan. Earlier, when the government put up the proposal, I think it was really pathetic. In that proposal, I only saw, people, virtual people are not real people. The government, they don't know about anything about farming, about the soil and so on. The proposal failed to acknowledge or observe that the farmers have spent three generations of time to build up their homes in those villages. In the proposal, we don't see the neighborly relationships and the community built by the farmers. And the proposal doesn't mention the fact that the residents living in the vicinity, about the relationship between the farmers and the relationship with the residents living in the vicinity. In the proposal, you only see a piece of vacant land, and then the bulldozer will come and fill up the land, and then you can start building properties there. The proposal doesn't, in that proposal, we don't see any living creatures. The development proposal claims to help resolve the housing problem in Hong Kong. I think this is the same lie as what Mr. C.Y. Leung has said. In other words, he used the pretext of developing public housing, but in reality, he's actually helping the developers. It is claimed that there is a shortage of housing, but there are many new residential units completed, but they're not used to accommodate people. They are used for speculation instead. The government talks about environmental protection, but they would allow condone the developers when they hoard up farmland and then they will fence off the land or to use the farmland as a container yard. Since the farmland is already in the green belt, why is it that this is happening? Furthermore, on our farms, we are already starting to collect kitchen waste. Our farm has an area of about 2.5 million square feet, and we are collecting more than 2 tons of kitchen waste, which is used as fertilizers and then the products so that we can grow products that we can sell to the community. The AFCD encourages people to resurrect farming and conduct organic farming, but the chances for us to do that is even harder than if we're on the waiting list of public housing. I've been operating my farm for a long time. I will not easily give up my farmland.
No legislation, no demolition, withdraw the rotten development plan. Mr. Zhang Fanghong, thank you. I have a question before I speak for you, Mr. Chairman. It seems that we don't have a lot of panel members. A few officials are here, but not Mr. Paul Chan. We are very disappointed. Do you have a quorum requirement? And also, do you have any specific requirement concerning the groupings of members present? And what can we do after we have spoken? Is this really a show of disrespect? May I also ask one further question? Are you going to arrange another meeting in which you ask Mr. Lau Wong Fa, Mr. Paul Chan, and other panel members who are absent today to be there? to be there at the public hearing? First of all, we have invited the secretary. It's up to the secretary to decide whether he will come. Equally, we have informed all members of the panel. We have reminded them of this, and it's up to individual members to decide whether to attend or not. The chairman, Mr. Lau Wangfa, has already applied leave long ago. And I'm the deputy chairman of the panel on developments, and I'm chairing this public hearing in accordance with our rules of procedures. So we can have a recorder, PA system, and a deputy chairman, and we can have a meeting. Well, in accordance with our rules of procedure, we need to have a quorum of 10, chairman included. But of course, sometimes the members would come in and go out occasionally. And of course, the number of members attending this morning is different from that for the afternoon. I don't know whether you are going to count if you have got a quorum, but let me say what I want to say. We have spoken at length, but it seems that people are just reading our scripts. We want the administration to resolve problems, not to create more problems. This is a polarized community that we have. We have more and more cases of injustice, and the administration will just tell you that we have heard you, but they are not going to solve the problem sincerely. For North East NT, the senior official will tell you that this is for our future, but they cannot really tell you for whom the plan is hatched. And who are going to be the beneficiaries? They can't give you any details. But the innocent residents in the three areas will have their homes destroyed. They try to get to some understanding, but no official can explain things to you. Is there no need to explain, or is it that you cannot explain? The public consultation exercises are even more outrageous. You consulted the district council, the Hung Yi Ko, and the rural committees, but you have failed to reach the people who would actually be affected. So they have not been consulted, or their views have been distorted, but therefore the officials will always claim that we have hurt you. But they will continue to do what they want to do all the same. They have no sincerity. And the villager will be affected, their homes will be destroyed, their voice muffled. That's what the administration called the long-term development. In the long run, everyone in Hong Kong stands to be adversely affected. This development plan has not reaped any benefits, and we are seeing disadvantages now. Many people will have their lifelong labor destroyed, and their homes demolished. We can see that there are people who would resort to all means to distort your views, but the victims would be just ignored. So this is a very retrogressive approach for public consultation. So can the officials explain to us and address our concerns and queries, especially the residents in the three districts whose homes will be demolished for this plan? And also, members of this panel, please bear witness for the residents in the three areas. Please witness for us that this is what the government is going to do. They are going to destroy our homes and affect our next generation. No relocation, no demolition, withdraw the rotten plan. Next, we have Mr. So Wing Yui, Chairman. Good afternoon. I'm from Takuling Ping Che Ping Yong Village. I oppose to the NT and North East NT development plan. We have someone from the Liberal Party, so I have this question for them. You support this van. Have you really gone through the entire plan? Have you read the documents? Do you know how much land will be resumed in the three areas, and how much land will go to the public housing, and how much to private development? And what about the six industries which would enjoy priority treatments? If you haven't done your homework, you shouldn't be here. I would like to get an answer from him. Or you can choose not to respond. Or you can respond. But he will be using your time, Mr. So. As I said, we in the Liberal Party are not saying that we support the plan, whatever comes. We want the land, at least half of the land, to be used for public housing. Let me answer you. Please go. Mr. Yang, please go if you haven't done your homework. Your information is totally inaccurate. We're not talking about information. That's what we want. That's our aspiration. You want to support it? Okay. Well, I'm chairing the meeting. I don't want deputations to be talking on their own. A moment ago, I invited Mr. Yang to respond at the request of Mr. So. It doesn't mean that I will allow you to have a dialogue between you two. So, Mr. So, please continue to give us your views. Well, if they haven't researched into the information, I hope that they will not be saying that they support the plan, because you don't really know the plan. So on what basis can you say you support it? Political reasons, or you try to gain votes? I see Mr. Tin have a flag planted at Taku Land Rural Committee. I just want to know whether you come here with the backing of full research or with a total lack of detailed knowledge. Well, I think, Mr. So, you have made yourself abundantly clear. Let me repeat this. You are invited here. You have 3 minutes. Please make use of it to express your views. Other people may have expressed somewhat different views, and we have all heard them. Well, some of my time was wasted. Can I be given more time? Well, I said already that Mr. Young would be using your time, but he hasn't given me a reply. Well, that's a question of choice when it comes to what to say. Well, I'll see if we have more time later on for you to speak again. My name is Yip Yi Wing from Shedwu Sun Chun. Let me say that I'm totally in objection as far as this novice anti-development plan is concerned. Let me use a soft approach. Let me tell you what is life at Shedwu Sun Chun. There are still people who live there and work there. I've been living there since I was born. Well, my father moved to the village in the 50s. When I was young, my father worked in a factory processing the duck feather and other feathers. And my mother also took up some jobs to supplement the income. When I was young, we had a very happy time playing with various things in the village. And many people, many villagers have fond memories of their youth in Shedwu Sun Chun. And now, five of us in my family, three generations, are living there. And we have we plant trees, flowers, and other leisurely activities to balance out life pressure. You may say that we really enjoy ourselves or our lives there. And it's not just that there are only five of us there every Saturday. our brothers and sisters who have moved out after they got married, and they would also come back with their children for family gathering, or we would have a dinner together. We would have a good conversation. That's a very comfortable and leisurely life. Transport is not very convenient. I will have to go to Lim Wo Hui in a minibus, and then I will take a bus to go to the urban district to work. You may think that I waste a lot of time doing this, but to me, well, that's the living style that of mine. And I enjoy the view, enjoy chatting with my neighbors, and there are also farmers there growing vegetables, and it's a very pleasant scenery. Living is not just about financial gains. So life is also about the meaning of being alive. Concerning the government's API, it seems to suggest that there are no people in the village. Actually, there are many people living there. How can the administration be so careless? We're not saying that there should be no development, but you should develop the abandoned land. You should not just ignore our presence. Lastly, let me say that Mr. C.Y. Leung and Mr. Paul Chan should step down. The Northeast NT plan should be scrapped. Mr. Li Mokyun, Chairman, members, good afternoon. I'm Li Mokyun from Fu Tai Hau Concern Group. I'm here that to tell you that Fu Tai Hau villagers object to this Northeast NT development plan. I've lived in Fu Tai Hau for 50 years. My father lived there. I myself and my children have all been living there. We have a very good lifestyle. We know that every inch of the environment. Fu Tai Hau, the name suggests of a crouching tiger. Villagers kept poultry, fish, keep fish and plant fruit trees along the coast. Well, they don't have any quibble with other people. They have a very small and self-contained community. This is rare in modern-day Hong Kong. Now their orchids, their farmland, their fish ponds, and all the water and trees and the natural environment come together to constitute a very natural green belt. And they also provide a habitat for migratory birds and local birds. It's a part of a green belt linking up with Long Valley. It has a very high ecological value, and it costs the administration nothing as long as you allow us to preserve it. Second, according to your development plan, outline development plan, part of Fu Tai Hau's land will be earmarked for agriculture, and some will be used as a firing range for the police. Well, I object to this. For the following grounds: one, the driving trainings and firing range for the police have already got designated facilities. There's no need for them to move to Fu Tai Hau, and they will be evicting other users for the police. This is not justified. It's not economically feasible. And if you embark on major development, you are going to wreak havoc to the ecology. There are 100 households there. 40 of them are facing eviction. The government should take care of these villagers who are going to be relocated. Otherwise, you go against your own approach of people-based governance. Can I carry on for one more minute? Well, we don't have time. Well, we should conserve the land. It's going to be beneficial all around. No relocation, no demolition. Withdraw the rotten plan. Mr. Liang Guiming, I'm also from Fudeiao village. Originally, I didn't know what was meant by government business collusion. And then I realized that they wanted the land for a driving school. Because they couldn't find another site elsewhere. Isn't this government business collusion? I would like to get an answer from the secretary. Anything else? Please continue. We have elderly farmers who have been living there. Well, three generations of their families have been living there. Well, they used to keep poultry, and now the river has been drained. No more. There's no more flooding. We can have a good life. And now they want to drive us away for the sake of development. So half will be for conservation, another half for driving school. You are trying to drive a wedge between villages. You are being divisive. I just don't know how come they plan the development like this. This is wrong planning. Can I get some response? In due course, I'm going to invite the permanent secretary to respond. Have you got other points to make? Well, I have been objecting to this plan, Northeast Anti-Development Plan. You are going to uproot our agricultural industry. Well, we need agriculture. This is the first essential part of our food chain. If you drive farmers out of existence, then you have nowhere to put your food waste to. It's just like the elimination of the poultry trade. You're now facing the undesirable consequences because of your poor planning. You are going to get your upcomings.
So you will depend on supplies from the mainland. Now, if they suffer from natural calamities, then there will be a shortage of supply and the prices will go up and the major food retailers will make a lot of profit by raising prices. And now the poultry industry has already suffered. Now you spend a lot of money disposing of food waste every year. Next. Polytechnic University Applied Social Science Society, Ms. Chen Suk Mei. I'm representative of our society. We study social work and social policy. We try to help people who are underprivileged. We feel that the villagers are under a lot of pressure and they are overlooked by the government. The government has not sought their views. They are forced to relocate from their homes. Their social network will disappear. That will affect them a lot. Now, the 2008 consultation was linked to mainland officials. They talked about integration and then they talked about housing development. So we wondered, where is it all leading? Now the residents are not heeded in the views, and the developers try to gain something in the process. In the past decade or more, the government, we have seen the developers use wire mesh or to surround the sites and pour concrete into the land, and this is the way they assemble land for themselves, and they force the local residents to move away in this manner. Now, the government is not making sure that the villagers are properly compensated. They are forced away by such indecent means. Now, many students feel that the rural areas and the cities can coexist. We see that the Ma Po Po Community Farm has forged strong links with the community. It's all very humanized. Why is it that this mode is being overlooked in favor of the financial development? Now, the government should adopt proper means. It should not allow the developers to get land in this manner. There should be proper hearing of views from all sides, the village, from the including the villagers themselves, and the NENT development plan should be set aside until consensus is reached. Next, Ms. Chen Chi Wai. I live in Fanling. I speak as a resident. Now, when people choose to live in Fanling, they spend more time in during the travels. But we go back to Fanling, we spend more time on our way, but we enjoy better air and it is less crowded. Now, the government is trying to move the major shopping centers from Causeway Bay and Tsim Sha Tsui to our area. Have they consulted our views? It has a major impact on us. We chose to live in that area. For instance, in the past mid-August festival, now some of my students asked me to join the activities in at Ma Po Po. Now, I lived in Fanling for over 10 years. I never heard of the government consultation. Now, I only learned about it after a widely reported incident. Now, are people being given a proper chance to air their views? Now, on the advertisement issue, suddenly the government launched a major advertisement campaign. Now, actually, it's taking up public time. The government might as well use the time to remind people against drugs or drunk driving. And yet the government is using this time to achieve certain political objectives. Now, the advertisements should be used to remind young people not to take drugs or not to drive after they drink. When the government launches such campaigns on such a large scale, well, we wonder what's happening. I'd like to formally ask the officials to respond to what the CECY Leung said. He said that he would lay out the maps of Hong Kong and ask the developers, those people who oppose his policies to find land in Hong Kong. Now, Well, most of us here are quite willing to attend such a meeting. Mr. Xi Leung and his officials should lay out the maps and we can all find land for development. Are we all willing to attend? Now this is an invitation by Mr. Xi Leung himself. Next, Mr. Chen Kwok Kei. I'm an ordinary resident. I am against the NENT development plan. I want the plan to be set aside. There should be a fresh consultation. Now the government can speed up redevelopment of old urban areas. It can redevelopment existing housing estates. It doesn't need to develop NENT. In some old areas, for instance, Kowloon City, Sham Shui Po, the areas are getting dilapidated, and the government should take the initiative to redevelop these old areas and offer different types of housing and not just let the developers acquire them or let the sites sit vacant. The government says that it will redevelop the old public housing estates. It's been estimated that 40,000 new public housing units will be supplied. This will already exceed the 23,000 units that the government expects to get from development of NENT. Now, in the private market, figures show that the developers and the MTRCL have sufficient land to build 91,000 units of 700 square feet. If it's all developed, then I believe many Hong Kong people can find homes to live in rather than let the land sit idle. The government should also look at the development of the outlying islands such as Mui Wah on Lantau Island. Now very few people go to Mui Wah because the facilities are out of date. Now you can have some reclamation there and there can be new housing developments there. Now on NENT development, on the employment figures, I am very puzzled. Now it said that Kwu Tung North 35,000, Ping Che North over 10,000 jobs. Now these are remote areas, especially Ping Che Ta Kwu Ling. If you take the minibus to Ping Che from Lin Wo Hui, at least it takes 20 minutes. So what's the attraction for Hong Kong people going there to work? And you mentioned a commercial center, diversified development at Kwu Tung North, Ping Che North, advantageous industries. Now these require skills, skilled people. Now the local people will have limited benefit from that, and people will have to travel from other parts of the territory to go there. So who does it benefit? And I don't want to repeat what others said about ecological value. Also, the consultation process is from top down. Those non-indigenous residents are the most affected by the land resumption, and yet their views are entirely overlooked. This is lacking of justice. So I object to the NENT development plan. I ask that the proposal be set aside and that there be a fresh consultation. Next, Mr. Chow Kwai Yin of Yau Tam Mei Village Concern Group. In our village, we have engaged in farming and keeping fish. Now, so the water source is vital to us. Now, the MTRCL is building the express rail link. So at our village, they are digging underground and they are building also superstructures. Now these safety exits are very large in size. Now, since these works have been commenced, our village has been affected by a lot of problems because they use explosives to conduct blasts underground, our houses crack, and the ground subsides. And for these, in order to build these safety exits, they pump away the underground water, and the underground water level sinks continuously. Some of our wells have already dried up, so our villagers depend on such water sources for farming and for our fish ponds. And especially the fish farmers, they are terribly affected because they are not they depend on underground water to replace the water in the fish ponds. Now, we keep raising the issue to the Express Rail Link company, and the company keeps saying that has nothing to do with us, but it's due very clearly to their work, because when they are not working on the site, then there's no such problem. If you build such a huge tunnel and such a tall vertical shaft, certainly our underground water will be affected. Now, we think that this is purely red tape on the part of those concerned. The government departments cannot help us, and of course not the Express Rail Link company. So we feel that we cannot get help from anyone, even though the Express Rail Link company tells us to get an expert to provide evidence that their works are affecting our livelihood. Yet we are mere villagers. Where do we get an expert from? So our homes are being destroyed. We want to voice our complaints at LegCo. Otherwise, we will fight with our lives. And if that still doesn't get us what we want, then there may be something more drastic. Thank you. Next, Madam Cheng Ho.
政府要高鐵.
The government wants Rail Link, Express Rail Link. We do not want that. I am a villager of Ngau Tam Mei. I was born and raised there. At Ngau Tam Mei, I've been living there for over 50 years. I love Ngau Tam Mei. I love our home. It's a beautiful place. It's been surrounded by hills. It's surrounded by hills on three sides, and it faces the bay, the deep bay. First, you look at this well. It's been there for decades. It was filled with water at the time it was born, but now it's totally dried up. I'd like to ask the chairman, water supplied once every 4 days, 4 hours each time. I'm sure you experienced that. But even in those days, there was plenty of water. It's now dried up. Now, we used to drink water from this well. Now, the Express Rail Link said it's got nothing to do with them. Li Wenghao, he is an Express Rail Link engineer. He said that there is ebb and ebbing and the subsiding of water that affects the wells. Hong Yat-ping, Mr. Hong Yat-ping, you are from the CEDD. Do you think that's correct? Now, the Express Rail Link affects us. You see all these cracks? These are our houses and the underground water. Now they raise fish, the Kamle fish, they are very precious. They are worth hundreds of thousands of dollars, and yet all the fish die. We can't get the government officials to help us. Are our complaints going to help us? We don't know. We are merely talking as if to thin air. What's the purpose of our speaking out here? Are you going to help us after we speak out? We really don't know. Now, the Express Rail Link work started in 2008, and by now the Altamay villagers are able to come to voice our complaints for the first time. We are mere common people. We ask you to help the Altamay villagers because many elderly people depend on such water for drinking, for growing vegetables and keeping fish. Now, if you those who engage in organic farming, you know that you can't grow good vegetables with tap water. Next, Mr. Ng Tat Yun. Now, the Express Rail Link is being built at Ngau Tam Mei in 2008. They said that there was a consultation, and yet it's just like that for NENT. It's just only known. It's known only to those at the rural committee and a small clique of people. It's a false consultation. Now, you look at this water. You let the water move around, you look at the change in color. Now, I took this water from the river this morning. Now, your engineering departments, your planning departments, did you monitor the works that you sublet or subcontracted to certain companies? The EPD said that they will sue such companies, but they are still doing the same thing. Have you gone and seen what they do? Now, the EPD has certain independence. They are trustworthy, but when I made complaints, they might feel that this project is the project of the government, of the Express Rail Link company, so we have been forced to complain to the district councillors and to legislative council, and only then are we being heard. Now, so I'm even starting to doubt have doubts about the Environmental Protection Department. So the government departments, including those who subcontract out the works, are they being partial to the Express Rail Link? Now, of course, we cannot stop the works after they have been contracted out, but they should not pollute the river. That affects those who grow vegetables and raise fish. And now nothing is being done. The EPD ignores what's happening. Where do we go and complain? There's no place for us to get to be heard.
So,
all the deputations present today have already spoken. I would like to remind you that if you have your written submissions, please put down your name and pass them on to our staff so that other electrical members can better understand your views. It's now time for members to ask questions. Are there any members who would like to ask questions? Let's stick to the 3-minute rule for the time being. Assembly Lau. Thank you, Chairman. We'd like to thank all the deputations for taking the Saturday afternoon to come here to express your views to us. There were more than 100 who attended last Saturday. We also have more than 100 today. We all know that the public has strong views about this plan. Of course, there are other people who support this, including the Liberal Party and the other members and political parties, which are not present here today. On the 24th of October, on behalf of the DP, I move a motion asking government to withdraw this proposal, but many parties, including the Liberal Party, objected, so my motion was not passed. But anyway, I hope the administration must listen to the views of the people, because next year it has promised that it will respond to the views of the public. I hope you will continue to speak out so that the administration can hear your views. But now, today, the secretary is not here, the permanent secretary is not here. We don't want to make things tough for the officials present today. I hope you've heard the submissions and reflect them truthfully to your colleagues. The golf course, I hope some part of the golf course could be taken out for development so that that your land would not be affected. Mrs. Yong Kin Sang, you said that you are one of the victims. I also asked the same question during the earlier session. Well, the administration, especially the secretary, said that he didn't want you to be forcibly evicted. But in fact, many people have already been evicted forcibly, and the administration has not been able to help. The parent secretary said that there's no freezing exercise yet, and therefore the government cannot come in to help. I asked him how many people have been evicted, and he said he didn't know. Of course, I told him that if we, make an announcement, people will come back and report to you that they have been evicted. Mr. Yong, now given the present predicament, how do you think the government can help those villagers who have been evicted forcibly? I hope that the government can actually, come to our villages to find out about the situation of those who generally need help, rather than wait until you announce your compensation plan, because the situation would be totally different then. Because many of these people cannot stay on there for too long. I think the court had already issued letters to them. They may be evicted in a few months' time. These are the people who need to be, resettled and protected. Shouldn't the administration go there and find out from these people what sort of assistance they need? For those who are entitled to public housing, we're talking government policy here, but there are people who are not eligible. So how are you going to help them? Is the government going to do nothing? For people who generally need assistance, they're being neglected. Okay, I think your time is up. We still have four other members who would like to ask questions. I also like to reserve some time for the administration to respond. Fernando Zhou. Thank you. I think it's very sad hearing the submissions today. And we really are sorry for asking you to come all the way here to make your submissions. Actually, your livelihood, you need to defend your lives and your livelihood. And we see that we are now in a very ridiculous situation. We are also very concerned, but you can see that the government is refusing to do anything. So I'd like to ask the administration this question. That is, even before this plan starts officially, many residents have been subject to all kinds of nuisances over the past 10 odd years. Either they're being evicted from the land, or the environment is being polluted, or the land is being fenced off and polluted. And also they don't know what the future beholds for them. So they're living without any sense of security. I'd like to ask the administration whether you're willing to go and meet with the residents there. Could you go to NE, Northeast NT, go to the three districts there and and you know, engage in a real dialogue with the residents and see how you can help them cope with the difficulties that they are facing. Chairman, I have actually submitted a motion to yourself. I hope that you will deal with it during this session so that we can listen to other deputations in the following session. I'll ask the Deputy Secretary to answer the question as to whether they're willing to you know, go to the Novice NT to consult. I think the planning for the NENT development, I think we've conducted three rounds of consultation during which we've tried our best to reach out to as many deputations and residents and affected persons as possible. Today is another opportunity. So we'd like to respond by saying that our secretary had already had a prior engagement, therefore he's not able to attend. And the undersecretary also need to attend another official function. So I've come here today and I have chairman. He's wasting my time in not answering my question. My question is very clear. I didn't name any officials. I'm now asking explicitly whether Paul Chen will go to the three districts in NT Northeast and have a direct, question and answer session with the residents. Of course, he will not be able to answer the question, but would you be willing to take this back to the secretary? Chairman, can you deal with my motion? Well, I'll talk to you after the end of this session as to how we can see what we can deal with it today. Chairman, I have some concerns here. First of all, we barely have a quorum today, and my motion is very clear. I think that we should ask the government to withdraw this plan and to stop the misleading promotion. If we could deal with my motion during this session, then at least this panel would have a chance to express its opinion. We've listened to the deputations almost for a whole day. I'm sitting here feeling totally helpless. There's nothing I can do. I think at least honorable electrical members should have a chance to express our views. I've read your motion. We still have another session later on. Let's discuss later on how we may deal with your motion. I want you to deal with the motion first during this session. Whether yourself or other people would like to, take account as to whether or not we have a quorum, that would be difficult. Why don't you deal with my motion now? Basically, we do not have a quorum now, even now. Chairman, Sloan Kok Hong. I'd like to thank the villagers from Yau Tang Mei. 2 or 3 weeks ago, I actually went to see them during the time when I was also filibustering here in this chamber. I think Yau Tang Mei is a very good example. When the express rail project was proposed, the government claimed that it was invincible. They promised told them that asked the government. They said that the government should ask residents to make concessions, and they would come to them with public housing units. But what is happening to the Yau Tang Mei villagers is that the government and the express rail company is actually bullying the residents by asking them to engage an expert to prove that the works are polluting their water and the farmland and causing cracks in the buildings, and they were asked to engage an expert or engineer to prove that the damages are caused by the government project. That is simply asking them to do the impossible. So, in NT Northeast, if we support this proposal, I think there will be disastrous consequences. I think what the government is proposing this time, I think they've done a worse job than the X-Rail project. At that time, I had tried to filibuster, but I couldn't. the time was not yet ripe. I don't want to talk about Northeast NT for the time being because I think I need to speak on behalf of the Yau Tang Mei villagers. Mr. Chan, when are you going to meet with the villagers? You tell Paul Chan to meet with them. Although the project was not initiated by him, it was initiated by Eva Chang. We don't know where she is. Of course, officials come and go, but now that the residents are, the villagers are in this kind of predicament, how are you going to do? What are you going to do? When will you be meeting with them? When will you, you know, ask the people responsible for the expressway project to meet with these villagers? Are you going to pay for, you know, an assessment, right? Actually, the X-ray, so I think you should actually. Well, the lecture had given you support for the expressway project, and the project is actually an MTR project by the MTR, which is also partly owned by the government. Will you relay? I think the member has raised some other issues which I need to take back. I'm asking whether you relay this message back to Paul Chan, the secretary. I think all the views you know, expressed today, I will relay them to the secretary. Okay, in that case, the villagers from Yau Tang Mei will go after you in future. Chairman, this PowerPoint is actually the document given to LegCo during the third stage of the public consultation. It said clearly that the government doesn't want to withdraw this plan, and at the time Paul Chan said he was willing to continue to listen to views and happy to communicate with the stakeholders. We had more than 100 today and more than 100 last Saturday, hoping to, you know, express the views to the administration. But the secretary on both occasions have been absent. So I'd like to, well, Mr. Wan Ho, Madam Wan Ho Ying also, you know, urged electrical members to move a motion to conduct a public hearing. So, Mr. Chan, please relay this back to Mr. Paul Chan that he should go and meet with the villagers as soon as possible. Secondly, Mr. Chen Kin Ching said that in North NT, the government has repeatedly deny that this is a project for integration between Shenzhen and Hong Kong. The former convener of the CPU, Professor Lau, also admitted that, except that Mr. C.Y. Leung, knowing that this North NENT project is a project to integrate Shenzhen and Hong Kong, but the government is very, very arrogant and unwilling to listen to views, and we want to draw the plan, and you refuse to do that. I'd like to say that in future, we'll continue to speak out. We will continue to put pressure on the administration, both within and outside this chamber. I believe this is the only way to force the government to adjust the NT Northeast development plan, and also this will, you know, have a bearing on whether or not agriculture can continue in the Northeast NT, and whether or not the government will agree not to evict and demolish the structures and evict the villages. Yesterday at the transport panel, together with Tan Kah Piu from the FTU, moved a few motions to the chairman Chen Kam Lam, and he also dealt with those motions, and they were both carried. Mr. Alan Leung has just come in. I believe we already have a quorum. I think we should deal with Dr. Fernando Zheng's motion. Chairman, if a member has moved a motion, you should deal with it. But today, the main purpose of the meeting is to listen to the deputations. We've divided the hearings into several sessions because there are too many deputations. And we also have a specified time for the meeting. I therefore think that we should listen to all the deputations before we deal with the motions. This session will end at 4:30. So what should we do? If we keep on talking, the next batch will not be able to come in on time. After we listen to all the views, and by 6 something or 7, if members want to continue with the debate, I think we can do that. But we still have several dozen people waiting to come in, and I don't think we should deal with the motion now. Mr. Chen Katlok, thank you. According to, I think it would be best if we deal with it this according to our rules and procedures. But if a member has moved a motion, I think we can also deal with that as well. To be fair, I think we should deal with it. That's my personal opinion. Procedurally, I think that should be the understanding. As for the content of the motion, it should be for the member moving that motion to explain its content and persuade us to support the motion. Chairman, you've listened to all these different views. I think you should deal with the motion as soon as possible. I have a question for Mr. Chen, the Deputy Secretary. Can you simply respond by telling us why after we've gone through 3 rounds of public consultation, the government said that it will allow a few more times for amendment. Why is it that there are still so many people coming here to this chamber, you know, complaining, you know, scolding Paul Chen and yourself? Can you explain why that is the case? Can you explain why we are facing this sort of situation? Do you have an answer? Deputy Secretary. Thank you. Also, I'd like to thank Mr. Chen for the question. Both today and last Saturday, and even at earlier development panel meetings and at other consultation fora, the Secretary had met with the local deputations and resident representatives. We've heard different views. Today, we've also heard some objecting views, and earlier we've also heard views in support of our proposal. We've also heard some specific and different views regarding the proposal. We will study all these views carefully and try our best to respond and try to minimize the impact adverse impact for the residents. I don't think he need to continue. He's going to simply repeat the same old tune. Chairman, if you're right, then you can speak in a forthright manner. But honestly speaking, we're faced with the present situation simply because the government wants to save his face. Why is it so difficult? Why don't you tell us that there have been a lot of things going wrong during the consultation process? And the villagers who are affected don't even know what is happening. Now the villagers are about to be wiped out, and only then are they coming forward and taking the complaint against you. You say that you'll go back, and we ask you to withdraw the whole plan, and this is exactly the reason. And Dr. Zheng's motion is based on the same principle as Emily Lau's earlier motion. Shouldn't we withdraw the... Should we withdraw the motion? Chen Qichun, before I ask my question, point of order. Dr. Zheng has moved a motion and you've not dealt with it, and you've not given a very clear explanation. We are suspecting whether or not we have a quorum to deal with this motion. Emily Lau said that we should allow as much time for the deputation to speak out rather than taking up the time to deal with the motions. But I'd like to say that by the end of the fourth session, we may not have a quorum to deal with this quorum. And secondly, if, Mr. Chairman, you suspect that we do not have a proper quorum, then I think you have a duty to explain to the submissions. If a member asks for demands for account, now what's going to happen? Well, actually, I've read Dr. Zheng's motion. Of course, he suggested we should deal with it during this session. I said that we have one more session coming up, so I don't want to, delay the time for the next submission to come in. I believe we still have time in the next session. If we don't, then we can extend our meeting so that we can deal with the motion. Regarding the question of quorum, I think we all know clearly. Why don't you, go on with your question, Mr. Chen. I think once there is a motion, move, you have to deal with it. This is a point of order. Mr. Chen Chichun, I'm aware of the motion, I'll deal with it. But Mr. Chen Chichun, you can first finish with your question.
幾十蚊車嚟係有冇用咧？咁樣，首先好多。
Well, I ask myself whether by spending tens of dollars coming here and express your views, is that going to do any good? We don't know whether they are going to read your submissions. We ask questions repeatedly, and we don't have any answers. So I just want to be more focused. We have been talking about the API. Every time you run that API, it's like adding the or you are hurting them once again. You are going to rub salt into their wound. When is it going to stop? Well, you are trying to, you are being evasive. So I will just focus on just one issue. Deputy Secretary, please speak up. Well, I hope when I speak in reply, you would allow us to finish, and please do not interrupt. Concerning the API, as we have said, in relation to the engineering feasibility study for Northeast NT, we received a lot of views in the third phase of public engagement exercise. So that is apart from the residents and people affected by the plan. We have to enhance the public understanding of the whole plan, and so the API was launched to enhance public understanding of the plan. In August, the public engagement exercise was still going on. We noted that there were quite a few misunderstandings in the community concerning the development plan. That's why we would like to make use of the government API to inform the public about the planning objective, and that is for for meeting housing needs. Please. If you do not allow the Deputy Secretary to speak, how can he respond? Well, time's up for this session. Actually, we have exceeded the time for this session. Let's have a break of 15 minutes. We'll resume at 4:45.